First, I'll tell you, India is a place where, you know, the best of the ideas are generated, created, and executed. Whether those ideas are coming from different parts of the world or from within. I first of all congratulate all of you because I was jammed in the traffic and it was bhayankar traffic. This is what I just told Deepak, and I congratulate all of you that you have made it possible to reach here. So it is quite a big numbers we have achieved, and congrats to you Deepak and Anil. I am going to talk two different subjects. One subject I am talking not categoric, like, you know, I had my predecessor speakers like Pramod and Paras, both of them P's. They have talked very specific, very minute details. They have gone into so many analyses and their experiences and the way in which things can happen and cannot happen and why it can happen and why it cannot happen. I would like to make into two parts. My first part is going to talk about excitement. You know, excitement makes it possible for all of us. And excitement, I'm going to talk in general, that we are going to have excitement in technology as always. Whenever technology is talked about, first it starts with a dream or an idea which looks like not possible. So when Jules Verne wrote about 20,000 leagues under the sea, people talked, okay, maybe this is just a story. But then when submarine happened, we talk about technology, wow, great. I'm going to talk about three great scientists, you may call them, or you can call them the technology innovators, who have talked about socio-economic impact on every individual's life. Because technology takes us to a change as an individual, as a personality, and as a bunch on the society. I'm going to talk about these three individuals. The first one is Gordon Moore. He's the co-founder of Intel Corporation. In the year 1965, he has talked about an idea that all the integrated circuits are going to have the double component every year. And we have seen phenomenal, now that you know this has come true, so it is called the Moore's Law. And that Moore's Law has made it possible for the storage space as well as the computing power, the processing power. Now this gentleman had talked about this, and subsequently this is a reality in our life now, that, you know, he has talked about in many other places that human mind could be chipped just down the road 20 years. The changes can come, like, you know, today we are talking about things like iPad and iPhones. They are the excellent pieces of gadgets and usability which is impacting our life. Down the road 20 years, he says that we'll be able to have a chip in our body which will be able to take the images of our real life experiences. Whatever we are living, those things would be recorded. I don't need to actually memorize things. Things would be taken care by itself. So much so forth, he has talked, and all these things sounds like fairy tales to us. But the fact is, he's talking about just remove the chip and the whole data of your life experience would be with you, which you want to retrieve in the real time, or is someone else after your life is over. It will be available to each and every person. Now he's talking about this. This is going to make a personality change in our life. We are going to be different individuals. We'll have so much of memories. We'll have so much of confidence that, you know, the loss of the memory and stuff which we normally face after an aging process. I was talking to Vishwanathan Anand. Okay, we were having dinner together. He said, it's aging which makes memory loss, and once the memory is lost, my edge in the game is lost. The second gentleman, his name is Raymond Kurzweil. Now this person also has so many of the innovations on his name. One of the main is the voice recognition. He is the founder of voice recognition. He is talking about our APJ Abdul Kalam. He's talking the same language. He's talking about in our blood cells, in our blood, very soon we are going to have the robots. They call it nanobots. Those nanobots are going to be there, and thousands of nanobots is going to make our lives. Maybe the enlargement or the so many of the things would be taken care automatically. And the third gentleman I would like to talk about, Alwin Toffler, which I always mention in all wherever I would have talked. Alwin Toffler has said that in mankind's history, the three waves were very important. And there is a book called Third Wave, I hope most of us would have read. He's talking about the first wave is going to be of the, rather it was of the agricultural revolution. The agriculture and related economics was actually in place for more than 5,000 years. The second revolution was just before 200 years. It came in, it's called industrial revolution. And that made our, so much of socio-economic changes came into our life that people started depending not on man, people started depending not on family, people started depending on machines, people started depending on systems, people started migrating from one place to another. And this balance caused so many disturbances in our life, whether we observe it closely. He has mentioned in this book of Third Wave that the third wave is going to be the wave of technology, and technology is going to bring back everybody once again, and nobody will have to go to work, no transport required, no physical movement of a person from X point to Y point, and people will reunite, people will have more time, people will have so many changes in the socio-economic way. Now this is the excitement of technology, and these people are the ones who the whole world accept. The second excitement, I told you that there are three excitements. The first one is the technology excitement. The second one is our great Lord Rama. He said in the Ramayana once that api swarnamayi lanka nameko jagat sarva Janani Janma Bhumisha Swargadapi Gariyasi. He said that let there be tons of and tons of gold any other part of the world, but I would like to live in my homeland, my motherland, and that is India. He talked this before 5,000 years or maybe more. And the same language is talked by our Reverend APJ Dr. Abdul Kalam. He said that this is the country where, you know, you have 700 million young minds which if ignited and which if looked upon as an opportunity, it has a great potential. So the second excitement is we are in the right time. This 700 million young minds, out of which the demographic says that from the age group of 16 to 35, in next 10 years, the whole of the 1.2 billion population of India, out of which more than 40% people are going to be young people, young minds and youngsters. Now these youngsters are going to find out different ways, innovative ways, and they will find out different opportunities to make themselves successful. When they become successful, they accumulate wealth. That wealth will be a great market opportunity. So the second excitement point, according to me, is our young population, which according to demographics, they say that within next 10 years, most of the educated elite workforce or human resource is going to come out of India. The second point. The third point is us. We all of us are in ICT. When Pramod talked about he is from security, I congratulate you, Pramod. You mentioned very categorically that he is from security. But I have to say that, Pramod, you have a great personality of looking like a security person. Fantastic personality. Well, I have to tell you that the third and the most exciting thing what I believe is that we are all engaged in the business or some or the other component of information technology or communication or telecom. Now all these three are going to be one. So you know, when we talk about an IT person talking about cloud or a software person talking about the product, everything is going to be, you know, part of the same ball. So these three exciting things which I feel that this is going to happen in our life, and we are going to make it happen. My second part of the presentation is on behalf of MATE, Manufacturing Association Information Technology. I have to talk for MATE, the initiatives and plans and things which are done by Manufacturing Association in our country. I have Meenal, who is the Western Region Office Bearer for MATE. She is present with us. Well, the part of the presentation is, I will present the things. It's okay. Well, what I have received from Ashwini, I will tell you, Ashwini Agarwal has taken up as the Executive Director of MATE. And what he has to say, I will just put it forward. Point one is, we are looking at working with the complete ICT ecosystem to build the electronics industry and to build the nation. This is very important. The another point says that regulations are on the way which will impact the entire ecosystem on energy efficiency and e-waste management system, and more important, they all will act as non-tariff barrier to prevent non-standard products from flooding the market in a destructive manner. So this is a very important announcement for all of us in the trade. Point number three is on the ground, activations and advocacy programs from MATE will help deliver the value back to the industry, and will work with the members and member channel affiliations like TATE to build all the inclusive programs. Example, TATE has taken the concern on desktop BEE standards, and MATE is committed to the issues. Unless it is addressed, they will not rest. The second and very important point what is relevant to all of us, that you know, we are always the implementers, we are always the recipients of the technologies, we are always talking about brands and products and technologies coming from different parts of the world. Now here comes an initiative which is very, very important, and that is what India aspires for, and the government and the think tank is talking about it very loudly, and this is what I am reading now. We will give you the details of government thinking on supporting the electronics manufacturing ecosystem, including analysis of states and their value propositions. Also the details of forthcoming SIP, that is Special Incentive Scheme, comma, Electronic Development Fund, which is for the R&D, and PMA, Preferred Market Access Programs. These are some of the other regulations relevant to the industry. And I must share something with you, that our government has taken initiative for funding the fab in India with couple of billions of dollars. With this, friends, I conclude my presentation, you call it, or my talk with you, you call it. I congratulate once again Deepak and your team. Fantastic job you have done for getting this kind of people together under one roof. And last but not least, I take this opportunity without asking you. I am wanting everybody to keep silence for 1 minute for the lives lost in Japan. So I request all of us to join.